In today's video, I will talk about absolute value and the reciprocal functions. We all know the meaning of absolute value of a real number. So when a is greater than 0, the absolute value of a is a itself. If a is smaller than 0, the absolute value is going to be negative a. So for example, the absolute value of negative 5 is going to be negative of this number, which is 5, right? So now we talk about the absolute value function. We start with the easiest absolute value function, y equal to absolute value of x. How we draw this graph? We first draw the line y equal to x. Then anything negative, we will reflect it, because anything negative, for example, here this value negative 3 will become positive 3. So any value negative, we just flip it up. So this line, we will flip it up here. The new graph, y equal to absolute value of x, will be like this. And then we also introduce the new term piecewise function, because this function is actually defined by two different rules for each interval of domain x. So you can change it into piecewise function. So different two rules. If x greater than 0, y gonna equal to x is a line like this. If x is smaller than 0, it's gonna be y equal to negative x, right? Let's consider another example, y equal to absolute value of 2x minus 3. And again, we first draw a line y equal to 2x minus 3. And anything below 0, we're just gonna flip it up, right? So the new graph gonna be like this. The domain is x belong to real number. The range is y greater than or equal to 0. And if we want to express this into a piecewise function, we know two different rules. When x greater than or equal to 3 over 2, it's going to be itself 2x minus 3. If x is smaller than 3 over 2, it's going to be negative, and everything inside absolute value, right? If this is a, it's going to be negative a, right? So it's negative 2x minus 3. In grade 11, we already learned quadratic function. So here we also discuss the absolute value of a quadratic function like this one. So for this one, we first draw y equal to negative x squared plus 2x plus 8. So for this one, how we draw it? First, we know it's open downward, right? And then we can try to factor it by finding the x-intercept. So if we factor it, and we got two intercepts, that is 4 and negative 2. And because there's absolute value, we have to flip everything below 0 to the up, right? And this part flip up, this part flip up. The new graph gonna be like this. And if we want to express this in a piecewise function, we know that because when x between negative 2 and 4, the graph is positive, so it's itself, right? If x smaller than negative 2 or greater than 4, it's a negative value. It's, if we look this at into a, so it's going to be negative a, right? Okay, finally, we need to do absolute value equation. So for example, we have to solve this absolute value equation. How we do it? We can first change the absolute value function into a piecewise function. So this is a piecewise function. And then we can solve it. So condition one, if x greater than or equal to 5 over 2. So the absolute value itself gonna equal to the left to the right hand side. So if we solve this one, we get x equal to 2. But remember, x equal to 2 should, under this condition, x greater than, everything we talk about here is under the condition that x greater than 5 over 2. But obviously 2 is not satisfied this condition. So 2 is not a solution. Or 2, we say 2 is an extraneous solution. Extraneous solution just means not a solution. Okay. Case 2, if x smaller than 5 over 2, we continue solve this equation, we get x equal to 0. Here 0 satisfied this condition, so 0 is a condition. We can verify it by graph it in decimal. So the red one is the graph of 2x minus 5 absolute value, and the blue one is gx, is another function. We can put another function. So where gx equal to fx is their intercept. The intercept is what we want as a solution, right? So we find the intercept is 0, 5 here. So it's x equal to 0 and y equal to 5. Where the extraneous solution comes from is when we calculating in the first case, we pretend this line is an actual line, and there will be an intercept here. But actually, this line is just a half line, so there's no intercept here. That's where the extraneous solution comes out, but actually it's not a solution. Okay. Now we discuss the reciprocal function, y equal to 1 over fx. So again, we start with the simplest one, y equal to 1 over x. So the graph gonna be like this. We can draw it by picking points, right? We have 1, 1, 2, half, 5, 1 over 5, and x equal to half, y equal to 2, and x equal to 1 half, 1 fifth, and y equal to 5. So by picking points, we can draw the graph like this. And here we introduce new term, asymptote. And an asymptote is a line whose distance of a given curve approaches zero. So here, as we can see in this example, x equal to zero, x equal to zero is the y-axis, is a vertical, we say it's a vertical asymptote because it's very close to the curve but never touch it. And y equal to zero, or the x-axis, is a horizontal asymptote. As you can see, it's very close but never touch it. Okay, let's see another example, y equal to 1 over 2x plus 5. So we first calculate the vertical asymptote. The vertical asymptote is the non-permissible value of this one. So non-permissible value means is the value not permitted, right? Because as a reciprocal function, we know that the bottom or the denominator cannot equal to 0. So that means x cannot equal to negative 5 over 2. As you can see in this graph, x never pick a point at negative 5 over 2. So another thing is x equal to negative 5 over 2 is the vertical asymptote. And we also have horizontal asymptote, that is the x-axis. So we can draw the graph. Finally, because in grade 11, we already learned the quadratic equation, quadratic function. So we also here discuss the reciprocal of a quadratic. So again, asymptote is a non-permissible value of the reciprocal function. That means this cannot equal to 0. That means x cannot equal to 2 and negative 2. Or we say x equal to 2 and negative 2 is a non-permissible value. That also means x equal to 2 and x equal to negative 2 is 2 vertical asymptote. And we can also find the horizontal asymptote, because when x become bigger and bigger, or we say when x approach infinity, x squared minus 4 become very big, and 1 over a very big number is close to 0. That's why the x-axis is a horizontal asymptote. And we can also pick a point 0 and the negative 1 over 4 is the y-intercept. So then we can draw the graph like this, this, and this. Okay, thanks for watching.